Hello everyone. So in this lecture I am going to talk about the term symbols for hydrogen atom. So basically term symbol represents the electronic state. So in this lecture I am going to show you how to compute the term symbol for hydrogen atom. Generally computing the term symbol for general atom is bit complicated, but in case of hydrogen atom it is much more easier or simpler. So in this whole lecture I am going to show you how you can actually derive the term symbol for the different electronic state for hydrogen atom system. Now before start of my lecture, I just want you to remind you to subscribe to my channel Chembiosis. So as I have mentioned earlier, that term symbol basically represents the electronic state of any atom. So in case of hydrogen atom, as we know that it is only a single electron system, and that electron, it is in the ground state, remain in the 1s orbital. So that energy state or that electronic state can be signified or shown by the term symbol. Now as you can see that this is the way by which we can actually define the term symbol for hydrogen atom. So you can see that the first thing is the central letter L. So that L is basically the orbital angular quantum number it is showing. So suppose the if the electron is in the s orbital, then instead of L you will write the capital S. If the electron is in the p orbital, you will write the capital P. Similarly, if the electron is in the d orbital, you will write capital D, and so on. So this central letter shows that in which orbital the electron resides. So this is the first thing. Now if you go to the left hand corner, you can see that there is a term that is called 2s plus 1. So this term signifies the spin multiplicity. So basically, as I have told you that the hydrogen atom is a single electronic system which contain only one electron. So for that electron, the spin quantum number is basically half. So that's why the 2s plus 1, that value will always be equal to 2. So whatever the electronic state it is, the spin multiplicity will always be 2 in case of hydrogen atom. So that value is basically constant, which is 2. Now you can see the come to the right hand side, there is a term that is called the J. J basically called the total angular momentum. So in my older lecture, basically we have described that this J, that is the total angular momentum, which arises due to the coupling or the spin orbit coupling. So coupling between the electronic spin motion and orbital motion, and J can have the following value, that is L plus S and L minus S, where L is the orbital angular quantum number and S is basically the spin quantum number. So by using this equation, you can actually calculate the J value for any electronic system in a term symbol, which you have to write in that right hand side. Now let's say that for in case of the MJ, there is another term that is called the MJ. So this MJ is basically the J component of the total angular momentum. So this MJ can have any value in between plus J to minus J. So if the value of suppose the value of J is basically 3/2, okay, then MJ can have the following value, like 3/2, 1/2, minus 1/2, and minus 3/2. So you can see that the difference between the MJ value in between two successive MJ value is basically 1. So by this difference you can write out that the MJ value is basically can be in between minus 3/2 to plus 3/2. The MJ value can vary in between this two value, and you can say that total 4 MJ value we can write for a J value 3 plus 2. So let's see some example of how you can actually derive the term symbol for the different electronic state of hydrogen atom. So suppose the electron is residing in the 1s orbital. So this is basically the any ground state of an hydrogen atom, that in the ground state the electron will always, the single electron will always reside in the 1s orbital. So in that case, as you can see that as the electron is residing in the s orbital, so that L value, that is the orbital angular momentum value, will always be equal to 0 for s orbital. Okay, now as we have told you that the J value will be L plus s and L minus s. So L is basically 0 and s is basically half for hydrogen atom as it is a single electron system. So L plus s and L minus s, we have to take the mod value of both L plus s and L minus s. So that's why the mod value of this or this will always be equal to 1 by 2. So as you can see that as the electron is residing in the s orbital, so we have to write the capital S. Then in the left hand side, the multiplicity will always be 2 for any electronic state for hydrogen atom term symbol. And in the right hand side, the value of J that we have just determined is equal to half. So this is the term symbol for an electronic state where the electron is residing in the 1s orbital. So this is this state is basically showing the energy state of the electron where the electron is basically residing in the 1s orbital. Now suppose at first the electron is in the 1s orbital for hydrogen atom. So this is the ground state. Now suppose we supply some amount of energy, is being supplied, and this electron is being excited to one of the p orbital. Suppose this electron is excited and goes into one of the p orbital. So this state is called the excited state for hydrogen atom. And in that case, what will be the term symbol for that energy state? So this is one energy state, that is ground state energy state, and this is the one of the excited state energy state, but the electron instead of residing in the 1s orbital, it is excited and it now reside in the p orbital. So we have to determine what will be the term symbol for that excited state. So as you can see, as the electron is residing in the p orbital, so the orbital angular quantum number for p orbital will be equal to 1. So L is equal to 1. So the J value can be determined by taking the mod value of L plus S and L minus S. And so that's why we obtain J value 3 by 2 and half. So these are the two J value that we will obtain. So we can see that this excited state, electronic state, has basically two type of term symbol. So the first term symbol where J is equal to 3 by 2 and the second term symbol where J is equal to 1 by half. So in both cases, the spin multiplicity will always be equal to 2 and this central letter, that is capital P, will be always same, as the electron in both cases is residing in the p orbital. Now for this term symbol, you can see that the J value is equal to 3 by 2. So for that J value, we have obtained the 4 MJ values. So as I have told you that for a J value, J, the MJ value can be in between minus J to plus J. So as the J value is 3 by 2, so MJ value can vary in between minus 3 to plus 3 to. So in between minus 3 to plus 3 by 2, there are total 4 MJ values that were possible. So there are basically total 4 electronic states are possible for J value 3 by 2. Similarly, for J value half, so for this term symbol, there can be 2 possible electronic states are possible where MJ value is minus half and plus half. So there are total 2 electronic state for p is equal to for J value is equal to half. So you can see that for 2p orbital, there are total 4 plus 2 six energy states that can be possible. So that's why we have seen that in case of 2p orbital there can be total maximum six electron can be filled up in the 2p orbital, and if each in each fill up shows the each excited state or each energy state. So these are the thing that by seeing the number of basically energy state, we can actually determine that what is the maximum number of electrons that were allowed to fill in the 2p orbital. So you can see that suppose we supply more energy and now the electron is residing in the 3d orbital. So instead of going to the p orbital, if we supply further energy, if it is go to the 3d orbital, we will get different energy state for the hydrogen atom. So for d orbital, the orbital angular quantum number l is equal to 2. So that's why j value will be equal to 5/2 or 3/2. Now that's why we obtain two term symbol. So as you can see, you obtain two term symbol for j value is equal to 5/2 and j value is equal to 3/2. The central letter will be capital D as the electron is residing in the d orbital. So for j value is equal to 5/2, there can be total six possible mj states are possible. They are degenerate in a, so they have the same energy, and total six mj values are possible. Similarly for j value is equal to 3/2, there are total four mj values are possible. So you can see that there are total 10 number of electronic states are possible for electron that is residing in the d orbital. So that's why the maximum number of electrons that is allowed in the d orbital is basically 10. So this is the way you can determine the term symbol for hydrogen atom in any one of the energy states. So if you have any questions regarding this lecture, you can ask me through the comment section, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel Chembiosis. So in the next lecture I am going to talk about the hydrogen atom spectrum and what is the selection rule that is being needed for any transition for to see any spectrum for hydrogen atom system. So till then, take care of yourself. Bye.